It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. I'm Dave.
And I am Craig.
And this is the Wizard Product Review. And we are...
1 year old today.
1 year old today.
It's our birthday and we're very excited.
We're very excited. In fact, we've only got three reviews this week, but there is a reason for that. Because...
To be honest, we'll get to that in a minute.
We've got a huge competition later on.
But when we started the Wizard Product Review, I remember the first show and we said, oh, you know, I don't even know if we're going to come in and do it in the second week. And here we are 52 weeks later.
I think it was called Wizard Product News
in those days. Wizard Product News, yeah.
Yeah, and then you did some before we even got started, didn't we?
Oh,
where I just wanted to film it. And then what happened, Craig was doing the videos himself and I was kind of stood there going, no, talk about this. Say that. Yeah. And you kind of said, well, you come and do it as well then.
And then you did.
And we did. And it's a year on.
We've been arguing about magic for years. It's just that we're now doing it on camera in front of... A few people,
and thank you very much for watching everywhere. I can honestly say the Wizard Product Review is the highlight of my week.
It really is
and
for me as well.
However busy and crazy life gets, this is almost a day off coming here to look at magic products. And first up this week is a magic legend, Jay Sankey.
Now, we review...
Hardcore.
You know, Jay Sankey, let me tell you what I think about Jay Sankey. I think that Jay Sankey is one of the most creative geniuses in the whole of magic.
Well, he's come up with so many... I did that thing of his for years, where you burnt the back of a card, and, the burnt would travel.
That was on Sankey Sanders.
I remember,
that was on the Secret Sessions.
Was it? I remember doing it at a gig once and burning somebody's hand.
Really?
Yeah. Heated up the card and put it on their hand. They were like, whoa, God. And I'm like, my God, the public liability's paid up, thank God.
You know what? I think that there's not a working professional out there or an amateur or hobbyist that isn't using something that Jay has created at some point in his career. Some of the classics, he pioneered coin magic with his handling of the Hang Ping Chen. His paperclip is legendary. He's just fantastic. But the problem with Jay Sankey is I don't think he's got an on and off switch that tells him what's good and what's not in his head.
You mean like a filter?
I don't think he's got a filter. Yeah. I think that's fair to say. Yeah, he creates all of this stuff. And the problem is...
You've almost got to go through 30 things to find the gem, haven't you? The one gem.
Yeah. I always buy every single Jay Sankey item that comes out.
Do you? Because,
yeah, I do. And the reason is, I know that there's going to be a whole bunch of, for want of a better word, crap. But I'm eventually going
to
find
that one. So back to the DVD. Well, we've kind of justified it. You've got a DVD here with how many things? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 things on here. Mm-hmm. There's got to be something that's pretty good. And
not really.
I didn't think there was. Let's just go through it very quickly.
This is a DVD of magical bits and bobs.
Yeah, it's kind of like a puzzle with a ring and straws, and the ring comes through, and then you do that sort of puzzle thing where the two straws go through each other. Nothing. It's like the sort of thing you're in TGI Fridays and the barman goes, I do magic.
Yeah, and then it starts pulling out something like that.
Yeah, it's not that good, to be honest with you. But
Rapture is, he has a quarter and a penny, and he heats
up. The handling's awful, and he doesn't really do anything. I think it's an interesting prop at the end.
When the coin is
bent round the other one, but I don't think it's convincing as a sequence of moves. You don't believe what's happening.
No.
Evidence. This, to me, is kind of like, he thought of the idea, which is quite a good idea, because he's got a lot of passion when he's talking about the premise of this trick, where he's saying about the evidence of something that's come before and something that's changed and that sort of thing. He's talking about it like a crime scene. You're kind of watching it going,
this
is going to be a good trick. Yeah. And it's not, isn't it?
No. Basically, all he does is he shows a pack of cards. A
couple of Pharaoh shuffles.
Pharaoh shuffles, really.
That would be a good trick, yeah.
A couple of Zara shuffles. He pulls the tabs off the case.
And then at the end...
And then it all goes back together.
It's like a time travel thing.
You'd sit down and maybe come up with...
There's nothing exciting. But with Jay Sankey, you look at each next trick and you think it must be getting better.
It's coming up.
Rising drink up straw. Oh, please.
That was just terrible.
Didn't look good.
Entrance, that's the one with the tic-tac box. And you were thinking of far cleverer methods. Basically, you tear a corner off a card and you push it into a tic-tac box and you get a few special bits
and
pieces.
They're like ideas. It's like he's jotted things down in his notebook over the years. And he's just thought, I need to stick these on DVD.
Yeah, I think that the title, he missed a subheading off the DVD. It should have been hardcore, the stuff that wasn't good enough for my other DVDs. That's what
it is. He
printed it in black there, but that's what it should have said.
We've got spinal, which is a borrowed bill, tear the corner off and it goes onto the notepad, which is okay.
He's already done that with a playing card. Nobody, released it as a
nobody believes this is actually happening, though, do they, when they see it? And then the one kind of trick, if we scoot forward to the end, where you do actually get props, is a golf ball kind of production. He's got like a little postcard, and you don't get a golf ball with it, but... he produces a golf ball from the Greetings from Florida postcard, which looks okay, but at the same time, still not great.
And it's very angly and very... To be honest, I very much doubt that he's actually gone out and worked any of these items. And let me tell you why. There's a few examples. In Heist, was a thing where he borrowed... where he had a can of drink, he tore the tab off, put it inside the drink, took a coin, put it in some flash paper, lit it on the can, and the coin and the tab changed places.
Have you ever lit flash paper that close to a spectator?
He's got the spectator holding it like this, and he's putting the flash paper on.
You're going to say that, aren't you?
Yeah, that's what I was going to say, yeah. He's going to light the flash paper.
And it's this close, and flash paper does go up.
Yeah, it does.
And it does on the video. But yeah. I reckon he's doing it on a magician, mate, and they're going, yeah, it's okay, it's flash paper.
Well, yeah,
but a punter wouldn't stand for it.
No, you will never do that in the real world and not have the spectator drop the can on the floor, the flash paper goes off everywhere. That just says to me he hasn't worked this stuff. Another example was Babylon Band. That was actually quite a good trick. It was probably the only good trick on the DVD. He had a band with loads of letters on.
Yeah, although, how did he justify it?
That's what I mean about not working this. He said, this is his presentation for it. Oh, I was walking along the streets the other day and I found this band on the street. Some
found
street
it on the
person
floor.
Made it and I thought, oh, hang on, I could do a trick with this. What? Hang on. So you're going out and you're telling your spectators that you're a tramp pick up crap off the floor? What? Come on, you are a better magician than that.
The change looks really nice. I like that.
Yeah.
But that's probably the best magical moment of the whole DVD. I didn't find anything where I thought that even inspires me to work with any part of it, really.
And you know what?
There's nothing I'd use.
And I'd like to say that I was disappointed and surprised that this was not going to be a good DVD. But the problem is I've come to expect from Jay Sankey, it's either going to be a hit, and if it's a hit, it's a hit. Or it's going to be a miss, and if it's a miss, it's a miss. And in this case, it's just an absolute miss. You'll sit there for 3 hours watching the DVD.
It's not 3 hours long, it just feels like it.
Feels like 3 hours, however long it is, I don't know. You'll sit there for an eternity watching the DVD thinking, yeah. And then you'll at the end of it,
especially
you won't be losing anything.
Especially with a name like Hardcore, you're kind of looking for really challenging magic, something that's going to inspire you. And there isn't.
You might
exciting
get inspired
there.
By the presentations.
I'm going to give this 28%.
Nah, I think that's a bit high. I'm going to give it 15%. Unfortunately, not the best Jay Sankey release ever.
Right, so next up, after the lows of Jay Sankey, is Easy Coin Magic.
We've had quite a few
Ben
requests
Salinas.
For this. Everyone knows that I'm a big fan of coin magic, and we get requests all the time for people asking us what's the best DVD to buy to get into coin magic.
Of something that's going to give you a bit of an education.
Yeah, I mean, there's many good ones out there. I know that Eric Jones has done some really good ones. I know that David Stone's DVDs on Beginner Coin Magic are excellent. So are Michael Amar's Introduction to Coin Magic. David Roth has done some fantastic ones. And now Magic Makers have come in, and a guy called Ben Salinas, who's done a lot of DVDs with
Magic
Makers.
There's a lot of stuff on here, isn't there? There really is. You know, it covers holds, grips and palms. You know, finger palm, Ramsey subtlety, classic palm, cap subtlety, finger rest, fingertip rest, thumb palm, downs palm, back clip, back finger clip, deep back clip, back clip on your head, back clip on your shoulder. There's so many things. Edge, various clip, curl palm. Bendy palm, straight palm, white palm, JW grip. There's everything on there.
And then that's just grips.
I might
then
have made a few of those up.
To,
Utilities, Bobo switch, shuttle pass, Al Baker steel, friction palm, click pass, spellbound change, variation on spellbound change, hand pin chen.
Carry on.
There's productions, finger palm production, classic palm production, downs palm production, Le Homme mask
that's
production.
That's called Le Homme mask.
Thanks. Coin production from clothing, coin production from handkerchief. And then after productions, there's vanishers. Finger palm vanish, finger palm vanish. Variation, French drop vanish with multiple coins. Retention vanish. Thumb palm vanish, classic palm vanish. Fingertip retention vanish, striking vanish. JW vanish.
Next, jumbo coins. Stuff with jumbo even coins. Covers jumbo coins.
Tenkai palm, curl palm, full palm production, jumbo coin production, toss vanish, retention. Is this a 5-hour DVD? And even then, when you've learnt all the routines, all the moves, you then go on to the routine stuff you can do with those. One coin flurry, coins across, coins through handkerchief, coins through table, coins in pen, the matrix, Chinese coin assembly, fingertip, coins across, coins to glass, four coin production, three coin production and vanish, spellbound variation, two in hand, one in the pocket. Is all that really taught to a good standard?
It really is. It's very, very okay. Well taught. Ben Salinas is a very good teacher, and what I like about it is the menu system on the DVD is divided into sections. So if I need to learn a Ramsey subtlety, or if I'm watching a routine and I'm trying to learn it and he talks about Le Homme Masque, I can just go to the menu, click on Le Homme Masque, and just specifically learn that slide. So the routines are actually taught very, very quickly because I can go back and forward and look at all the different moves. So we've all been there when we've bought a book and the book says, now use your favourite vanish or use this move, and you don't know what this move is. You can go into the menu system, find the move, and then learn it. It's a much better way of doing it than just teaching the moves
in the routine. You certainly, like we did, wouldn't want to sit through and watch it all in one go.
No, because it's
a bit like, once you've seen one palm, you're kind of thinking, okay, I've got it now.
Yeah.
But it goes on
and
to more and
more.
And it did
bore me to tears, but that's because I know all this stuff, and it was very well explained. I was expecting, I'll be honest with you now, I was expecting to have to really go off on a rant about crediting, because they've made their own bed, now they have to lie in it, but due to actions over the years, magic makers aren't known as the best of creditors, you know, to be honest.
I think that's fair enough.
But I looked through it, and it's not perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but it is okay. For example, he teaches a version of fingertip coins of cross, or three fly, and he credits Chris Kenner. As soon as he starts talking about Matrix, he credits L. Schneider. He talks about the striking
vanish. He didn't credit David Roth at one point,
no,
did he?
I looked at the Chinese coin assembly. He doesn't credit David Roth. The one coin flurry, he doesn't mention Slidini or David Roth at any point. There's bits that he's missed off, and I don't know whether he's had permission to teach stuff like some of the things, I don't know if he's had permission to teach, but the crediting was acceptable. Not brilliant, but definitely acceptable.
So going back to the original sort of thing, we've put a few clips on the screen. If you wanted to learn coin magic and you wanted a basic understanding of coin magic, because you've got to remember, not everybody out there has been doing coin magic as long as you, would you hand them this DVD and say, do you know what, there's no better place you can start than with this DVD?
Definitely, definitely. I wouldn't buy it on its own. I'd also invest in a good book, maybe a copy of Bobo's, or maybe, Coin Magic by Kaufman, and then use that to follow along with the book. So you've got two different sources. But as a DVD, as an instructional aid to learn the moves and the intricacies behind coin magic, I think it's very, very good.
You sound very intelligent when you say that. I think World Magic Store have got this at a very good price at the moment as well, so check that out on worldmagicstore.com. I really didn't know what to compare it to because I haven't seen a lot of these DVDs. I do know a little bit about coin magic. I use what I need to know. I thought it was very well taught, and certainly if I wanted to learn any of the routines at the end, I could learn them from the DVD.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was a nice DVD. I'd give it 85%.
I'm going to give it 90%. I think for a beginner, it's very, very good. Don't use this as the be-all, end-all. Look into some of the other beginning DVDs as well, because they look at things from a different way. But recommended. Well done.
Actually, quite a nice surprise, because we thought it might be Neff.
Yeah, we were ready to rip it.
You have a water bottle cap, and you have a coin. You take one of the coins, and you place it underneath the cap. She's gonna hear and feel the coin inside the cap. And at any moment, you can actually get the coin to vanish.
Okay, put your hand right on top. Okay, so I can't get in there. Watch, ready? Keep your hand closed, you keep your hand closed. Ready, watch. Done. Lift your hand up, give it another shake. Put it over. Put your hand up. What's awesome about this trick is it's very easy to do, it's easy to carry, it's 100% examinable. Once you put the coin underneath the cap, that's the last time you touch it. The spectator does all the miracles themselves. This is rattled. Make sure it's under there, give it a little shake. Perfect, okay? Empty glass, yes. I'm gonna place it right under here, and I want you to push on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three, push. Look. Put your hand up. Give it a little shake. Turn it over. Shake it back. Put your hand up, give it another shake, turn it over, turn it over.
Right, because it's our birthday, we're going to have a competition, and this really is a fantastic competition.
This is an insane competition.
First of all, we want to give everybody a gift. We did this quite a while ago with Wizard FX TV. We put your Ruffed DVD up there.
We did, we put Ruffed.
Still waiting for me to put something on there.
And iTunes needs updating.
Yeah, I know, but that's going to be a while just yet. We're going to give something away. It's your gift, so your gift to the
listeners. I'm going to talk about this. This was something that I spent the last year writing. It's called Flash, a collection of routines with Flash products. Now this isn't just stuff with Flash paper. There's routines in there with Flash paper, there's routines in there with Flash wool, there's routines in there with Flash cards, and there's routines in there with Flash string.
Right,
there's
okay.
like 15 routines together.
And some top magicians have given you like fantastic
quotes.
Yeah,
there's some really good quotes that I've had. We bought these out in a limited run for Blackpool, and I think they're sold out on the second day.
Yeah.
And the feedback I've had on this has been absolutely great. The routines on here are really, really strong. There's 15 routines altogether, including essence transposition, which you guys have got to see to believe, and also
what happens with that. Tell us what happens.
Okay, no problem. Well, basically, you've got two pieces of flash paper. Spectator signs one piece of flash paper.
Yeah.
They hold onto it. Another spectator holds on, signs another piece of flash paper. They hold onto it. Well, paper.
Yeah.
Paper. You just drop the paper down into a glass. It bursts into flames drop it down in the glass, and then when they take them out, their signatures have changed places.
Oh, cool.
So it's not just like,
I think a friend of mine, Mike Fitch, who I know watches the show, he's got this theory that any trick becomes three times better if you add flash paper to it.
Yeah.
And he uses flash paper with everything. He's just got this theory. I think that's what is the Michael J. Fix philosophy on magic.
Yeah, you know, add flash paper,
instantly the trick becomes better.
That's true.
So that's the
I've
perfect
got stuff
resource.
On there with trick tic-tac boxes, lighters, a whole bunch of different stuff. There's some really nice coin work on there.
And that's
well.
An e-book.
That's an e-book. There's 80 pages, I believe, and it's all fully illustrated. There's
and like, that's available
for free.
Right now.
What
for
we're
free.
Do, yeah.
For a limited time, you need to go on worldmagicstore.com.
Yep.
Get yourself...
You'll need an account.
You need to get an account on worldmagicstore.com, and then there's a way to download it.
Yeah,
but
well, basically,
what we'll
you
do...
Just,
basically, if you think we don't know what's going on right now while we talk about this, you're right, because we don't know. John behind the camera is the guy that gets all this sorted.
Yeah.
And along with Jim, and they promised this is going to be sorted. So if it's not there on the day this show goes live, it's their fault.
Exactly. But as far as I'm aware, they would go and they would just click on it.
I think there's going to be text underneath the YouTube. Do you think you could do that, John?
John's like, why not? Whatever.
There's going to be text underneath our YouTube video that'll probably say how to go and find this thing, and it's going to be free for our birthday. But
so happy birthday!
Everybody can have the Flash ebook, but one Just one lucky person.
Let's talk about what
gonna
we
get
got
this.
Here.
We've got a Canspo's refill pack right there. Got my lecture DVD.
Which has got in it the single best coin trick. You say you don't do coins.
Yes.
Circle to the fourth dimension. One of the best coin tricks you will ever see.
Street Magic Secrets 2.
Have you noticed something about Dave's DVDs? It's all the close-up of his face holding various objects looking very, very strange.
Normally an S fan or a fan of God. So, okay, yeah, enough about you. At least I appear in real form and not cartoon.
That's
okay, so Coinvex 2.
Which is £85 on its own.
Normally £85. You've probably got about £120 there. Refraction.
You're closer.
Yeah.
When you do restaurants.
The trick that got me the job at Buckingham Palace. No word of a lie. Canspost. Colleagues.
What's his face did that on TV not too long ago?
Ben somebody or other did that on...
So sorry, I've forgotten your second name.
On Daybreak.
Ben Hanlon. Ben Hanlon. So sorry, Ben.
And Banding Around by Russell Leeds.
Very good DVD.
My 21st century top it. We must be up to like £300 already.
I think
now.
We are.
Memento, a special gift from David Regal.
You did that at Lads.
At Lads.
Live at the Lads convention.
A special gift from David Regal for our viewers. David's a big fan of the show. And Craig Petty's Slim. You are in real form there.
There you go. I told you I wasn't.
This
one
is
of
getting
them.
Rave reviews on the forum. Check out Craig's physique in the sauna. Through the Ranks by Chris Webb.
Shut in a garden.
There we go. Craig Petty's...
I'm in real form there as well.
Locked in a room without coins. Craig Petty's Love Cards, along with Russell Leeds.
Which has to be the most non-heterosexual front cover ever. Like, me and Russell's name
in a love heart. I love this. This is brilliant.
You actually... Didn't you do that at Blackpool when you were doing the close-up?
I did this in my Blackpool close-up routine, which is Quarantine by Craig Petty, where, not like an Omni deck, the whole cellophane vanishes and it ends up sealed in.
Yeah, and then the box is sealed and
yeah, that's the best
sealed.
Bit when the box is sealed. Gunslinger, Banding Around 2. There's a wallet by Black's Magic, the card to wallet. Nefesh, Hot and Cold, and...
Well, you can't get those anywhere.
We've still got one. Yeah, we've still got one here. It's Chop!
And I think that is literally the only one left in the world.
No, we've got them. We've actually got them.
And we
World
have.
Magic Store. Right now,
but
we've got them.
We just haven't got enough to give anyone else.
We haven't got enough to give anybody else. But there's a copy of Chop, sold out everywhere in the western, that western part, over the ocean. But we've still got them there. There's Chop and... Linking cigarettes. There must be... How many hundreds of pounds worth is it?
I reckon there's got to be at least...
There must be at least $20,000 worth of stuff.
Oh, no. I'd say like about $50,000.
At least $50,000 worth of
yeah,
stuff.
Definitely. Yeah, definitely. And we're giving this away free.
Free. All you've got to do, right, to win this prize, we don't care what you put, you've got to leave a comment on the YouTube video.
No, I'll tell comment. You what they can do.
And you have to be a subscriber.
You have to be a subscriber and you have to leave a comment. And the comment we want to hear is what your favourite moment in the show was over the last year. So if you've
good or bad.
Yeah, good or bad. What was your favourite part of the Wizard product review last year? What was your favourite moment? And we'll put them all in a change bag.
Yeah, no, it will be fair.
We'll put them all in a bag.
Everybody's name, every YouTube subscriber. You have to be a subscriber. Make sure you hit subscribe.
Because we will check on the subscription thing.
You have to be a subscriber.
And then we'll pull it out live on the show next week. And the winner will receive all of that.
All of that, which must be $50,000, $60,000
worth of
stuff.
What was your favourite moment?
My favourite moment.
Other than just sitting here with me.
I think my favourite, which still tickles me even today when I watch it, is the Psycho Ball.
That was so funny.
That was. And yours?
It's one of two. Either right. Watching you fail over and over again at that jumbo card trick.
Yeah, they don't know the half of it.
No, they don't. You saw a couple of the outtakes. It went on for about an hour or two. I thought we were going to have that with the domino thing last week.
Oh, God, yeah.
Either that or shooting the iokinesis thing, because people honestly thought that it was real. I had some people coming up to me asking to buy iokinesis.
Oh my goodness! Yeah, we've done some strange things over the past year, I tell you. Oh, and I float.
The guys.
That was funny. Get out of here. And the thing is, when you're out working, say you've got your 10 favourite routines,
yeah,
you know, whatever they might be, you know, crazy man's handcuffs, whatever.
Yeah.
If you've only got a limited amount of time to impress with somebody,
yeah,
you've got to drop one of those routines. You might not do crazy man's handcuffs. You might want to do that. And Skip Switch would not stand up against crazy man's handcuffs.
David and Craig, I think the Skip Switch is better than Crazy Man's Handcuff any day. I'm willing to challenge you. Bring it on. Touch one card for me. Okay, it's a big decision. There's 52 cards. Touch the two elastic bands. One goes behind the other. Now tell me, guys, is there any way that I can pull this elastic band through the other one?
Yeah, you can break it.
I could break it. Thank you for that, Libby. I appreciate that. But this is the bit where you guys have to decide which one's better, the card trick, Ollie, or the rubber band trick. You guys get to decide.
Right, somewhere under here. Is it under here?
No, I moved it over here.
Right,
I moved
okay.
It out of the way, but yes,
here's
here
the
we
final
go.
Review. And this just happened by chance, because what happens every sort of Monday, a big box full of stuff turns up, doesn't it, with review stuff in. And next in the pile was another Jay Sankey item.
Yep, another one. Jay Sankey Insider. We've just trashed his last one to bits.
Let's synopsisize it first of
okay.
all.
Okay, do you want to do that or do you want me to?
I can synopsisize it.
Go for it.
Basically, you've got an envelope. Well, there's lots of different ways to use it, but you've got an envelope. And
a window envelope,
and you can see either nothing inside the envelope, and you can then just make something appear inside it.
Yeah.
And the good thing about this, you can immediately hand that envelope
and they
to the spectator.
It.
They could keep it, they could open it, and what they find inside is genuine. There's no gimmicks or anything at that stage. You could have something inside the envelope, and they can clearly see it visible through the window.
And by something, it can be anything. I mean, he said here on the back, playing cards, predictions, business cards, dollar bills, baseball cards, Pokemon cards, randomly. Photographs, letters, file cards, even a signed playing card visually appear or change inside a legitimately sealed window envelope.
And that's the nice thing when you actually hand it over to them, and it's just an envelope and that object is inside. And I did like his handling of the signed card.
I thought it was excellent. He's got a wonderful way of having a signed card appear inside a sealed envelope, which you would then give out to the spectator and they can keep it forever with their signed card inside, or as you said, when they open it, you can put a business card in there.
Yeah, and there's also the thing with the business card where he tears off the corner of a business card.
Mm, that's
and
excellent.
Then the business card appears inside there. Mm-hmm. There's so many great ideas. The bottom line is you watch this, you want to start playing with it.
Yeah, I
this
mean, the DVD goes on forever. This is a worker.
In fact, it's Worker of the Week.
Worker of the Week. I don't think anyone in history has ever had a Worker of the Week and what is in essence like a product that's been absolutely trashed in the same show.
But this is definitely a Worker of the Week.
It's fantastic. It really is, guys. This is a DVD that you want to pick up. It really is.
As long as you're comfortable holding an envelope and that sort of thing, it might not suit everybody's style. You have to have that window envelope with you. If it's the sort of thing you don't mind carrying around, having in your inside pocket, the effects do look very visual
they
indeed.
They really do. And you can be set up to do it all night and have like 10 or 12 envelopes prepped, or you can just not seal the envelope during the course of the routine and reuse the same envelope throughout the whole of the evening if you're cheap. It works really well for an amateur, works really well for a hobbyist. But it works really well for a pro as well. It's organic, for example, I love the Kennedy box, you know, the mystery box.
Yeah.
And I know Chris Priest does some wonderful things with it, but what the hell is it? You know, this little wooden box.
Yeah, yeah.
What's nice about this is it's an envelope. You know, everybody knows what a window envelope looks like. And the fact that you're not just having to use playing cards, you can use money or anything that you want to. It makes it
this
so
illustrates
organic.
Perfectly what we've been trying to say about Jay Sankey's filter. He doesn't have one. This is better than anything on Hardcore.
Mm-hmm.
Even all the stuff on Hardcore added up together isn't as good as that.
Isn't as good as this. This is such a worker, and people are going to buy this, and they are going to use it.
The moment it appears in the envelope is so visual,
so
and the fact
strong.
You can give that away afterwards is just fantastic.
Genius.
I'm going to give this 94%.
I'm going to give this 96%, and obviously it gets the Worker of the Week.
Congratulations, Jay Sankey. That is it for our birthday episode of the Wizard Product Review.
I can't wait to see who's going to win the £50,000 worth of magic.
that lot there that we value at £50,000.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Basically all your my working repertoire.
We've had a great year. If you want to leave us a comment on Facebook, say what you've think about the show or anything. I don't know. I feel like saying something quite moving and that.
Yeah,
but
I really do.
Nothing's coming to my lips right now apart from thank you so much. It's the highlight of my week.
It's the highlight of my week. It's been very humbling having you guys. I'm trying to think of something emotional.
We can't.
John's laughing at me behind the camera now. It's making me feel
I feel
silly.
Like we need some like emotional music going on,
John,
in the background.
John, you got any emotional words that we can part with?
What should you say,
come
John?
Come on, John. What do we say? What do we say now? We need something.
Come John, on, John.
Help us, John.
Have a good next year. It's the highlight of my week. Hopefully, it's the highlight of yours. Lots of people have got in touch with us over the year to say it is the highlight of their week.
Yeah, love us or hate us, we really appreciate you watching us.
We've got no friends on the Wizard product review.
Even less than when we started it.
But we've got quite a few viewers and we appreciate every single one of you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. We'll see you next week. I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
We'll see you next week on the Wizard product review.